I think the alleyways also represents the comprehensiveness of Chinatown CDC. So the alleyways project started with the youth. You all went out and graded the alleyways, ABC, to show the city that they needed to do more to clean up the alleyways. And from there, it's grown into many different segments mm-hmm. of the program. And so the youth still do the cleanups every month, and they do a great job. We also run a capital improvement project where we actually work with the city to create more beautiful alleyways. Mm-hmm. In some of the alleyways, we've gotten rid of parking, we've gotten rid of traffic, and we've made it more pedestrian friendly with lighting and decorative items on the ground, things like that. And also just thinking about the alleyways as the open space in Chinatown, it's so dense. So thinking about how to use the alleyways as open space, as a backyard, as a living mm-hmm. room. And part of that is just having fun in the alleyways.
And if you haven't, by the way, been able to check out the alleyways in Chinatown, you are missing so much. It's amazing. It's like Disneyland. It's like a trip, you know, through the city. That's what's so wonderful about our city is that each little neighborhood has its personality. And boy, you can go fun. And my kids and I like to go to the rice paper candy and the one that you can eat the wrapper.
Oh, you can eat the wrapper.
Yeah. You can eat the wrapper. That was amazing.
And the fortune cookie.
The fortune cookie factory. Yes, everything. But it's so amazing and so culturally rich. Mm-hmm. And as we were speaking before, the pagodas, the temples, the look is so ornate. How did that come about?
Well, actually, after the 1906 earthquake and mm-hmm. fire, they wanted to move Chinatown out to Hunters Point. And some of the smart folks in those days said, wait a minute, we gotta preserve Chinatown. So they created this idea of making Chinatown look like China, even though there's a little mythology there, mm-hmm. but they created roof top oriental eaves and stuff like that, and convinced San Francisco that we needed to keep Chinatown there, mm-hmm. and that's why we're still here.
And then also the North Beach mm-hmm. was called North Beach because it was actually on the water. Is that though? I heard someone say it. No problem. At that point, that it was the water was right there because it didn't go down as far as the Embarcadero.
Right.
That was built on the ships that had come for the gold rush and sunk, and they built over that landfill.
That's right. Financial District, you're on landfill.
Just like financial is on landfill right now. Everything.
That's right.
Yeah. So let me see the housing development. We were talking about that. What are the issues that you work with, the challenges with the housing development?
A lot of the challenges in Chinatown right now are that the buildings are so old. Some of them are somewhat falling apart. They need to be renovated. But what's really important to us is to preserve the affordability of the buildings. Mm-hmm. We just want to make sure that they're, whatever changes that Chinatown goes through over the next decade, over the next 50 years, we want to make sure that the people that live there now stay and participate in what's created, stay and can see all of the great changes that may happen. Mm-hmm. And so just figuring out the balance between incentivizing owners to upgrade the housing, but also preserving affordability at the same time.
Mm-hmm. And affordability in San Francisco with new housing is quite a challenge.
It's the greatest challenge. It's very difficult, but I think that's sort of what we work toward every day.
Mm-hmm. When I grew up in Chinatown, one of the worst things that happened when I was young was I was evicted, and somebody from overseas bought the building and kicked us out. And at that moment, I knew that we had to do something to preserve the housing in Chinatown. And one of the key missions of Chinatown CDC is to improve and enhance the housing that we have. And what I love about Chinatown CDC is that we've preserved and renovated a lot of buildings, mm-hmm. those SRO buildings even. And we built new housing creatively on top of, we built the first air rights project over a post office, Larkin & Pine. Mm-hmm. We built the first one over the public housing parking lot mm-hmm. land, right on 77 Broadway. We are very creative and innovative thanks to geniuses like Cindy here. I'm so proud of her because she won't let me brag, but we stole her from MIT. And uh-huh. she could have worked for city planning or something else, but she wanted to help the community. I just love all the Cindys of the world and all the folks that want to come back and help preserve our neighborhood.
Mm-hmm. Why did you choose to stay in the neighborhood?
I always wanted to work in community planning, and there are actually very few organizations, even in the country, that do this type of work. Mm-hmm. I think that city planning is often looked at sort of methodically or bureaucratically, and what we're really doing is empowering people in the neighborhood, teaching them about planning issues, teaching them about how City Hall works so that they can make the land use decisions for themselves that affect their lives.
Mm-hmm.
They can decide if they want education in the neighborhood. They can decide if they want stores in the neighborhood. They can decide if they want housing on the ground floor or housing above, and what they want the neighborhood to look like. And I really wanted to do it in a grassroots way, and that's what really drew me to Chinatown CDC. Mm-hmm. And Norman.
Oh, the love here.
Oh, yeah, we love each other.
Are you getting good support from local politicians in all your endeavors?
Wow.
Mm. Well, I heard San Francisco Access interviewed the new president of the board,
David
Chu. I
had him on Friday, and he was lovely. Yes. And did mention about the housing conditions being a problem in Chinatown and working on that. So he is also from that neighborhood, first elected official president of the board.
Yeah. And he worked with us at Chinatown CDC. He helped us on a number of housing cases in Chinatown, and so he gets it. And actually, I think San Francisco gets it.
Mm-hmm.
We're really good at trying to preserve our neighborhoods.
Yeah.
And that's why everyone loves San Francisco. There's only so much land, and the quality of life that we're preserving, it's really important.
Mm-hmm. And the cultures.
And the cultures.
Very important to hang on to all of them.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
That's what makes our city San Francisco.
Yeah, exactly.
So tenant services that you offer, what type of tenant services?
Well, we've built 2,200 units of housing or enhanced old buildings, and each one has residents in there, and we serve them.
Mm-hmm.
So whether it's a 90-year-old senior who's Russian speaking, or families that are jam-packed in the SROs, we try to create programs that will help support them. Some of the youth don't have a place to study.
Mm-hmm.
And so we try to do youth programs like tutoring. The seniors, they love us because we always party. Chinatown CDC, we party. Oh, it's Chinese New Year. Okay, New Year's.
Yeah.
Okay, St. Patrick's Day. Come on, everyone wear green. Let's party. I mean,
bingo night.
Yeah, bingo night, whatever. Well, that's a hot one. Let's not go there. But anyway.
Okay, I touched on something. I don't know what that is.
We're clean with that one. Anyway.
But, services also just does, they do like a coffee shop hour day or every week, so that if tenants are having any issues, they need some technical assistance, help figuring out some sort of process or filling out forms, something like that. Just to have someone to go to be able to help them, I think means a lot. And that relationship building is what leads to the community that we want to create there.
Mm-hmm.
And again, we love the youth who want to partner up with the seniors. And we've done some field trips. We've done tenant services activities with them, and I just love it. That's cool.
And especially many of the youth have family members they have moved over recently and are working two jobs. The mother and father are gone out of the household to make enough money to actually live in our lovely city. And so they don't really have the parental support, and they don't have a grandparent there. So how perfect is that to be able to hang out with someone who has so much experience in the city and they each get from each other?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So we try to pull it all together.
Yeah.
The families.
I think we do a pretty good job.
Yeah, we do a great
Excellent.
Job.
Excellent. They do a great job. Wonderful.
That's why we're on TV with you, right?
Yes, because you're making a difference.
Okay.
Let's talk a little bit about the future, the Central Subway project.
Yes.
Why don't we talk about where it's going?
So the subway is the extension of the T3rd light rail. It's phase two of that project.
Mm-hmm.
It is going to come up 4th Street in SoMa and then into Chinatown along Stockton Street, but it will be underground.
Mm-hmm.
We are really excited not only for the infrastructure of the subway, but what it might bring otherwise to the neighborhood. I think that it will increase access for people who want to come to Chinatown, but also increase access for people who live in Chinatown might need to go to their jobs or might need to go visit family, say in Visitation Valley. I think that it will bring customers to Chinatown. It will help the economic development of the neighborhood. We are thinking a lot about what does the streetscape look like. You know, thinking about a subway coming in, there's going to be lots of people, pedestrians, how are they going to interface with the buses that are already there, so on and on. So thinking of it more than just an infrastructure project, but as a catalyst for changing Chinatown, for I don't want to say reinvigorate, because I think Chinatown is full of vitality right now, but to bring even more to the neighborhood.
Mm-hmm. And bring people to experience Chinatown, because right now it's so crowded, there's so few buses that it would be a direct line linking Visitation Valley, Union Square, Chinatown all together to make it more easy to get around the city.
Yeah.
In closing, just wanted to know, you have the Arts in the Alley
Yeah, that's April 18th, right?
April 18th in Waverly Alley from 11 to 4.
And what is that?
We're going to be showcasing all sorts of arts, so music, visual art, performances. We just want to enliven the alley and bring people to Chinatown to see what it's about, traditional, modern art. It's going to be really exciting.
It's mm-hmm. going to be a party and a
You like
alleyway
to say party
fair.
A lot.
Yeah, I do. But what we are going to showcase, too, is our youth tourist program, mm-hmm. too,
uh-huh.
because they tell the story behind all 40 alleyways. And
wow.
There's so many great stories. If you're a San Franciscan, how can you not know about our stories? Did you know the Beatles came after their performance in 64 at Candlestick,
uh-huh.
they came to Chinatown for a drink. Where did they go? Which bar did they hang out? You'll have to come on the tour to find
out.
Oh,
no, he's leaving a cliffhanger for us.